Hi friends, welcome to LinuxFork. My name is Chandan and today we are going to learn how we can deploy a MySQL workload on Azure cloud. Okay, so in this tutorial I will show you how you can deploy a MySQL workload on Azure cloud. Currently this service I am going to use as a PaaS service. Okay, and this PaaS service is completely managed service. Okay, so what do you mean by managed? Managed is basically one of the term on Azure or any cloud services. Okay, on any cloud, like either you go for the AWS, Google or Azure. Okay, so managed means everything whatever the management level work is there, all they are going to manage by the Microsoft. Okay, and we are not going to manage that, like any configuration and other things, failover, any component security, these component, high availability, all these things they will take care. Okay, our work is launch that MySQL and connect it and use it. That's it. Other things they will take care. Okay, some flexibility they are giving, like some configuration file you can change, some parameter you can change. So they are giving options. I will show you what are the options they are giving. So that part only you can change. Okay, other part we can't change. Okay, for changing other things you need to request them. If they are going to change, okay, then it's okay. If it is not possible, they will not change you. Okay, so here the things is like you can scale in, scale out whenever you according to your need, right? So these are the flexibility, and even you can take it as a backup. You can manage very well these things. Okay, so let's start this and then I will explain whenever any term is coming. Okay, so how you can create, just search in global my global search bar MySQL. Okay, so just click here, you can see two terms is coming, two MySQL is coming here. One is Azure Database for MySQL Servers, and one is other is Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Servers. So this one is coming soon. Currently it is in previews, so I'm not going with that. I'm clicking here Azure Database for MySQL Server. I think I'm there only. Okay, now click on create and choose. You can see here, right, that to flexible server, it is in preview now. Once it completely launch, we will see it also. Okay, so basically in this actually they are giving some more option. I have seen that for the cost optimization. Okay, so that is the main advantage of choosing this flexible server. So they will give little bit configuration and other option also. So like cost optimization is the main motive for this feature. Okay, they are coming up. Here I am going with the this single server. Okay, so let's click. In hidden part is nothing there. It's just a resource group. Okay, in which you want to deploy your infrastructure. So just I have chosen my default one, demo. Okay, here is the main thing. Okay, you need to give the server name. Okay, so enter server name, anything you want to enter, just enter here. I'm adding MySQL DB. Okay, so I have given, it's not taking. So you can give any other server name. I am giving Linux Fork ओके सो इट्स टेकन. ओके नाउ दे आर गिविंग द ऑप्शन फॉर द डेटा सोर्स नन बैकअप. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इनेबल बैकअप यू कैन क्लिक हियर एंड दे विल डू वॉट दे विल डू दिस ऑप्शन अलाउ यू टू रीस्टोर फ्रॉम द मोस्ट रिसेंट जियो रिडंडेंट बैकअप ऑफ एनी सर्वर इन दिस सब्सक्रिप्शन. सो इफ एनी रिडंडेंट बैकअप इज गोइंग ऑन फ्रॉम दैट यू कैन रीस्टोर डेटा फ्रॉम एनी प्लेस लाइक दे आर मैनेजिंग यू. इफ फॉर दिस यू नीड टू रिक्वेस्ट देम. ओके सो डाट इज द थिंग्स. हेयर यू कैन चूज द रीजन. हेयर दे आर गिविंग लेटेस्ट वर्जन 5.6, 5.7 एंड 8. 8.1 इज द लेटेस्ट वन. सो यू कैन चूज अकॉर्डिंग टू योर नीड. ओके हेयर इज द जनरल पर्पज दे कंप्यूट स्टोरेज. सो यू कैन सी डाइट. सो हेयर दे आर गिविंग द स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी एंड अदर सेटिंग्स. सो सपोज इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर द प्रोडक्शन इफ यू आर टेस्टिंग. सो दिस इज मेमोरी ऑप्टिमाइज अकॉर्डिंग टू योर नीड यू कैन चूज द ऑप्शंस. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग फॉर द टेस्ट सो आई एम जस्ट चूजिंग द बेसिक. ओके सो इट्स नथिंग इट्स कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कोर. सो कोर एंड मेमोरी. सो इट्स it will give the performance according to performance you can choose. If there is a highly high performance database you need then you go for the memory optimized. If in general you can go for the production you can choose general purpose. Okay and for the testing you can choose the basic one. So I am just showing it. So I am just choosing basic. Here they are giving 2 core and 50 GB space and 7-day backup retention period. And here I have chosen a storage auto growth. So it will auto grow once 50 GB reached it will automatically extend. Okay and here I am here is the option local redundancy redundant. And if you go to the general purpose maybe some other option will come. Core is there 100 GB the basic they are giving. Okay here you can see 300 available IOPS is there. And then here they are giving geo redundant. Geo means multiple place they will put your database. Okay so if you choose geo redundant it will go like that only. And similar you go for the memory optimized maybe some other option will come. You see for the production you can choose between these two. If you are going for the testing you just go with this basic one. Okay I have chosen the basic one and clicked okay. Now you need to give the admin username. So I am giving db admin. According to your need you can give anything. And I am passing the password. Okay now just confirm it. Okay next go additional setting. Here is the one option. Okay so actually this option is for encryption. Okay so this option they are going to it's a double encryption they are saying right. So once you click here now it's your database it's going encrypted. Okay with the double key they will manage all the things in backend. Okay so they are saying a storage is in database and backup is encrypted by default with service managed key. Infrastructure double encryption is an additional infrastructure encryption layer using a secondary service managed key. You know so these things is there. So and also they are saying tuning it on impact database performance. So tuning is also there in if you enable these things infrastructure double encryption enabled. Okay so currently infrastructure encryption cannot be enabled in this section selected region. So currently this feature is not available in this region, that's why it's coming as a gray. Okay, this grayed out. So this option is not available in this region in which I am going to launch. Okay, so let's go next. This is tagging. Currently I am going with the you can give the name, it's optional. According if you want to give, then you can give. In production you can give. Okay, I am testing, so I am not giving here. Go next. So all these things is done. You can see the costing, how much they are going to charge you, right? So cost is very high for this. And next, click on create. But the things is cost is there, but it's very good. You can manage your things very well, okay? Because anything, a scale in, a scale out, all the feature they are giving. So it's very easy. If your infrastructure is like dynamic, it's a huge request continuously, it's going on, and a huge database increment, then it will be very good for you. Okay, so just I am deploying this. It will take 1 or 2 minutes. Just wait. Okay, so till that time, what we can do, how we can download MySQL Workbench. So just I am showing you, just search on Google MySQL Workbench, click on this option, okay, mysql.com, and click on download now. Here they will give, okay, this option. You just click on here, download. And here you can choose, you don't require login and other thing, just click on no thanks, just start download. Okay, I have already downloaded and installed. Installation is very easy, normal Windows installation, so nothing need to do much more here. Okay, so I have installed, so just I am going to open that. Search MySQL, it will come here, just click on open. Okay, so it's opened. So just I want to show you how we can connect this data with and how we can use it. Okay, so let's see. Either still the deployment is going on. Okay, so done. So just go to resource. Okay, so guys, as we can see, the deployment done. Now we need to connect this database. Okay, right now how we can connect this database, these things, let's see. Okay, you can give the server name anything here. For just go to MySQL Workbench, click on plus icon, it will come. And here a connection name, you can give anything. I am giving my db connection. Okay, now come to host name. Host name is nothing, your server name. Okay, here it, they are giving server name. Okay, just copy it and paste it. Okay, next is username. Just go to that and copy this one, server admin login name. Okay, this is your username. Copy it and paste it. Now you need to store password. Okay, so what password you have given, just store it. Okay, admin @1. Okay, I have given the password. Now the things is, all the things is done. One thing is spending. We need to keep the IP whitelisting, okay, on firewall. So I'm searching what is my IP. So my IP is this one. This is my public IP, okay. So I'm copying this and I'm allowing on firewall. If you did not allow this IP on firewall, you will not connect it, okay. So just I'm giving the name, anything, any name you can give, and a starting IP and end IP, okay. I have given. Now just save it, okay. Okay, so okay, it's done. Now just go there and try to connect. You can test connection also, so just click on test. If everything is fine, it will come like this. So successful made the MySQL connection, it's going on. Just click on OK and double click here, okay, this on this connection. Now you can see, right, we are able to access that database. How we can check some, you can perform some query here. So databases, okay, I'm executing this command using, you just click on here, so you can see default database is coming here, right? Information schema, MySQL, performance schema, and sys. These four databases is the default database for MySQL, as we know. Okay, so it's coming. You can create a database, you can create database, and you give the name of the database like Linux fork. Okay, just execute, it will create it. Just select this one and then execute it. Can you create database Linux for database exists? So this database is already exists, so you can give the name of the database Linux fork one, no issue. Now just perform this command, so databases, you can see, right, Linux fork created and Linux fork one also created. So these are the things is here, okay. And for advanced, you can see here this official site is also expressing the things like they are giving focus on application deployment, non database management. So if you have any like management level things, if you are not going to manage, you can work on your application only, okay. Management and other things will take care Microsoft, okay. So and they are giving high availability, advanced security and high availability. They are giving 99.99% SLA, okay. So you can migrate your on-premise database also on Azure. They are giving this flexibility also. How we can, you can migrate, they are giving the guides for that. So these are the things they are giving, lot of things, features here. So you can go through this document. I will put this document in comment section or in a description section also. I will put this document, you can refer this for the features, okay, what features they are providing, what a specification they are providing. So you can go through this document, okay, I will put it. And thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel. And these things actually give me a little bit motivation to create a video. So please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.